Hi, and welcome to another episode. We'll continue with the letter M. I have a lot of stuff on the letter M. So, let's get it started. First up, we have this, Miss Hirumi. Algleimi. I think Icelandic black metal, and this is their second album. Icelandic black metal tends to be more atmospheric and with folkish undertones. Not musically, but regards to the singing. I haven't really heard a bad Icelandic black metal band yet, so I think they know what to do. This also came with a booklet. The lyrics. If you don't speak Icelandic, you will have a hard time understanding. I can understand some of the words, and of course the ones in they also have an English translation, but yeah. But check that one out, it's really good. Then we have a Swedish Schenkpunk band. Misanthropic. And this is a collected release, so it's called discography, but so I guess it's almost all their work. A black vinyl. Some really nice D-beat stuff. And I think they are working on a new album as well, so check them out. Then we have the band Moloch. Really nice black metal. Black vinyl. And then a classic album, their first one. It's by the band Månegarm. Nordstjärnans tidsålder. The lyrics and some info from the band. This is a repress. I don't think it was originally released on vinyl, so it's quite recent release, but the original was released back in the 90s. And this is really great black metal in my opinion, mixed with traditional Swedish folk music in a great way. Sadly, they've strayed away from that path, so now it's more folk metal these days. It's not bad, but it's not as good as this one. They haven't released an album since this that's equally good. I think three or four albums after this was kind of black metal, and then it turned to folk metal and melodic death metal. More, they have some black metal elements still, but not much. So yeah, I regard those two time eras as different bands, because it's my way of accepting that they don't sound alike anymore. Then we have Mörk Gryning with I think this is self-titled, I don't remember at the moment. But yeah, really nice album. Not as good as their first and second album, but nice as well. Anyways. And then we have Mörk Gryning again, the one playing in the background. Tusen år har gått. Everyone that listened to black metal since the 90s knows this album. Kind of divided the scene into camps. One side hates them for some stupid reason, and one side loves it. It's one of my favorites. It's one of the first albums I heard in the black metal genre. Came with a booklet with the lyrics. Really nice. And also an interview with Goth Gorgon and Drak Chimera, as their alter egos is named. I got to see these guys live in March on Jönköping Metal Fest. November last year on November. Jönköping Metal Fest. And they didn't disappoint. And they also played a new track. So there's a new album coming. And that track sounded bloody promising. More back to the old ways. So I really hope that it will sound like this. Because this is just a phenomenal album. I think they were 14 and 17 years old when they recorded it. So to accomplish something like that in that age is just mind-blowing. Then we have Moro Moro Land, and this is the album True, and this is more of a post hardcore stuff with some doom sludge elements. Really nice release. And one of black vinyl. And then we have three albums left from a stoner rock band. I really like this band. Sounds very Black Sabbath, but with their own special touch. I got the mosquito in here. Mountain Witch. This is their second album, Burning Village. And if you like Black Sabbath, you will like this. Came with a poster. The front cover artwork. This came on a color frost brown vinyl. Really nice. And I bought this one and the first album directly from the band. So I got a signature thank you card as well. Pretty nice. And this is their first album, Cold River. Really nice artwork on this. And this comes on a yellow vinyl. Really bright yellow. And then their latest album, Extinct Cults. And this was released just a month ago or something. And this is the, well, I guess you could call it the Die Hard version. It came with a t-shirt design. T-shirt with a design for just this release. It's on a very bright yellow color. I didn't think this album was as good as their two other ones. It's good, but not as good as those two. And it's more diverse, but well, I like the other ones as well. These tracks kind of sound all the same, it's not so diverse. Came with a poster of the front artwork. This version also came with this. It's the artwork in a different color scheme. So, really nice. So if you like the old type of rock metal, like Sabbath and Black Sabbath and stuff like that, you should check these guys out. Really nice. So that's all for this episode. Yeah, hope you found something you haven't heard before or something you like. If you have something you want to recommend to me, please let me know in the comments below. Have a nice day.